do you know about God? And who taught you what you know about God? And what is the result in the life of that teacher? There is something you can learn about God. There is something you can learn about God, man of God. Hi. That will supply such a dimension of the anointing. Let me tell you this. I do not believe there is any mortal man on earth that can take my life. It's true. Now, you don't have to believe it. I'm just sharing with you. Sorry if I sound arrogant. It's true. You need to know the things that have happened in my life to know why I'm saying what I'm saying. The same way you see Donald Trump just walking without security, you try to shoot him and see what happens. Use anything, whether a gun or a missile. The military people are not standing there with guns, but you use your initiative to quickly shoot him. And that's when you will know that all you see is not all there is. Number two, I believe God loves me. And I truly believe, I hope I'm right, but forgive me, I believe that God loves me unfairly. Unfairly there, not because he is unfair, but the extent, it's as if he doesn't love any other person like that. It's true. Look at my life. So when your enemies are angry, have a heart for them. Don't hate them. Understand with them. Who will not be angry looking at such a life like this? You see, that revelation sponsors love. You too should be in their position and know it's not easy to see a man that God blesses anyhow. Anything about your life blesses you. What kind of a life is that? Because I have learned that he's a God that can make all things work together for the good of them that love him and those who are the called according to his purpose. Are you getting what I'm sharing with you tonight? Please learn these things. I'm doing something to your mind. You will walk out of this meeting with confidence, knowing that I know something about God. When a guy looks at you and you say you are not fine enough, you say, Lord, thank you for taking such an irresponsible boy out of my life. I cannot imagine living with someone with such a deconstructed revelation about me. No. Not that you go back and look at yourself in the mirror and say, is it really true? You mean I'm like this? No. God, who did not hide his jealousy for you, his love. Do you know what it means for someone to be in the position of God to come down and say, I love you? You say, Lord, I don't love you. You say, I will wait. What is more ego stinging than that? I will wait for you till you come to me. Then some guy somewhere comes to make your life miserable in the name of love. No, sir. I believe as a man of God that when God empowers you, nobody can bring you down. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So when you have this mindset, you expect to be accepted everywhere. Everywhere. When you hear them say they want to choose 10 people, you start smiling and pray for the remaining 9. It's not pride. It's not pride. It's not pride. It's true. Listen, it is important who constructs your belief system. It matters how it is constructed. It matters what about God you are taught. Please listen carefully. Many of us come from many backgrounds just like me, and there are many propositions about God that may be sociologically right. Listen carefully. It may even be from a well-meaning leader, pastor, whatever it is. And now that God has brought you to a very flourishing assembly like this, you must allow yourself to be reoriented, that God gives you another perspective of himself. You will never be able to walk in the anointing if there are some things about God you don't know. I do not believe that any man can meet me and actually make contact with me and his life remains the same. It's impossible. I don't believe it. I have indoctrinated myself by the Spirit to know I am a blessing. Are we together now? Yes, sir. Carry that mentality and let somebody sow a seed into your life and watch what happens to him. Even you will be surprised and say, you mean I'm disanointed? What did you say happened? You will now sow a seed to your own self to receive that testimony. There's a lot of weakness in the body. A lot of weakness. Spiritual weakness. Mental weakness as a result of something about God that we have been told. If God decides to kill everybody on earth, I'll be the last to die. I know that. Are we together? The anointing, listen. The anointing does not just function vaguely. It depends on these kinds of revelation. Whatsoever he doeth prospers, because there is a force. God backs him. Carry this mindset as a minister and let me see who closes the door of ministry. Where will it come from? Where will it come from? You produce an album and it does not get everywhere. What stopped it? There is a positive entitlement mentality you need to carry to take your portion in this life. I don't walk in life as if I'm at the mercy of anybody. No, sir. No, sir. No, sir. Don't sit down wishing to be someone else. No. Because there is something you know about God. God has spoken great things. Man of God, know this God. Know this God. Stand on the pulpit and let that God back you. And you watch the wonder that happens in your church in 1 month. Not two. 1 month. 1 month. Apostle, I don't know where my school fees will come from. As it is right now, I don't even know. I agree with you. I'm not inhuman. I agree with you, but let me tell you something. Where did the raven come from that fed Elijah? Is it not in your Bible? Please, let's look at this. It's either we are lying or this thing is true. It may take time, I know. But if it is God, bah. Palabora susia takata. Listen, some of you are seated here now. You don't even know. It's like an immersion happening to you. You may not know what is smearing on you. You will step out of this place and see things begin to change in your life. And then you know. Listen, listen, listen. Let me tell you how God makes men blessings. He makes men blessings by anointing them. You are not a blessing if you are not anointed. It's true. So someone's life is about to be destroyed and you just pass the person. You brought an atmosphere that prolongs his life. He does not even know that's what happened to him. You brought life and ministered to the person. Not formally. You carried an atmosphere that canceled what would have destroyed him and his family. And he just knows that someone came to buy a bottle of water in this shop. I don't know who. From the time he dropped his 100 naira, customers have come because you brought your atmosphere. This is what I believe. This is what I believe. I know there is a God that sits in heaven. I know that God can arise and judge the works of darkness. I know that. I know that when God decides to lift me, let me tell you, there are enough men to use. If you refuse, you will find another one. I know this. Everywhere I travel, I walk as if my estate is there. I expect something to come from that city. HICC, listen, let me tell you, if you carry this mentality, February will not finish before you start crying for joy and say, what is happening? What is this? You will come and meet your pastor and say, sir, I don't know what happened. I come from the north, and humanly speaking, there is a lot of disadvantage where we come from. You know, I didn't have the privilege of any family to, no leverage at all. But when God decides to lift you, I said it during the pastor's conference, when God points his jealousy at you, you will marvel and wonder at what your life becomes. And you see, when people begin to make all those noise, you know that this is the doing of God. And like an usher, you can say, God, you are the one who deserves all the glory and all the honor. Someone needs to know something about God tonight. Somebody needs to know, like Sinach will say, that he's a way maker. Listen. For you to understand what a way maker is, you have to look at Julius Berger when they are constructing a road. There are times that all you see is just a mountain, and they smile and say, this is where the road will start from. And they are pointing at a mountain, and they are already describing the dimensions of the road. And then they bring some high-powered gadgets and blow up that mountain and construct roads. So when you say God is a way maker, he looks at your life and say, this mess, this is where the miracle comes out from. Then it will connect to this one.